Spring game today for Ohio State. Buckeye Nation eager to see how the new-look defense would perform. And with senior quarterback Braxton Miller sidelined with that shoulder injury, anxious to see new backup signal caller Cardell Jones. Mark in Columbus with a full report.
Weather certainly lived up to the billing. A beautiful day, and after Ohio State slashed the ticket prices to just $5, over 60,000 in attendance for the spring game. But while Urban Meyer promised lots of big plays, that particular part of the hype didn't live up to the billing. Chris Ash, the new co-defensive coordinator, his Scarlet defense, the first big play of the game. Gray Balter owned two. Rashad Frazier in the backfield, the old sack fumble on JT Barrett. Frazier recovers, Scarlet up 7-0. Gray's offense gets back on track. Barrett to true freshman Johnny Dixon. A 10-yard gain would help set up a field goal. Second quarter, Gray at the Scarlet 2. Bronte Dunn coming off the redshirt year. Touchdown, 6 carries, 35 yards. Gray up 10-7. After a Scarlet punt, Gray's Warren Ball picks up 20 before being knocked out of bounds by Chris Worley. Cleveland Glenville grad has had a good spring. Third quarter now, Scarlet offense comes alive. Cardell Jones hits Cato Mitchell for a 27-yard gain. Scarlet ball at the 1-yard line. Curtis Samuel stuffed by Ron Tanner as the Gray defense comes up with a goal line stand. Fourth quarter now, Scarlet again deep in Gray territory. Corey Smith on the end around jukes Darren Lee, but true freshman Raquan McMillan tackles him. Smith fumbles into the end zone and out of bounds, touchback. Gray takes over. Later in the fourth, Warren Ball closes out the scoring. Columbus native, 8 rushes for 55 yards. Gray wins 17-7. Despite the lackluster offensive showing, Urban Meyer not discouraged by his team.
Oh, it's not fair to say discouraged. You know, you have Jeff Hierman, Braxton Miller, Jalen Marshall, Dalen, Dontre Wilson all stand next to me, and I tell them they can't play Decker and they can't play, you know, and I'll go chew out the coaches. You know, it's probably not the best thing to do, but they all know what it is. You know, we want. I just wanted to see a little cleaner throwing the ball, and we didn't do it. But I'm fine. We had a good spring.
What gives me confidence is my coaches being hard on me and my players around me picking me up when I'm down. Like our first half was terrible, as far as the Scarlet team. But just them guys in my ear, them older guys like Taylor Decker, even like some young guys who on defense like Joey Bosa coming to me and something like, "Come on, you got it. Pick us up, this and that." So that what gives me my confidence actually.
Cardell was disappointing. You know, Cardell's had a good spring. I thought he made some misses today, but I'm not going to let that ruin his spring. He's had a good spring for us.
You know, you're so used to through 14 practices playing with the same guys, and that chemistry started to develop through spring. Even though there was a lot of new faces, you start to develop a little bit of chemistry, and you know, there were guys flipping sides, playing both ways. So that makes it a little difficult. You're not used to playing with somebody, but you know, that's no excuse. You still got to go out there and execute and do your job.
Defense, I hope the reaction was that they look quicker, they look faster, they trigger on the ball much better than we have in the past. If that's your perception, that's mine as well.
Mike Miller, Buckeye Insider, joins us now. And Mike, to no surprise, Urban Meyer, a little uneven in his assessment, seeing the big picture that this isn't necessarily a team day. It's about individuals.
Yeah, you know, and that's understandable, certainly. I think it's a little bit of a change, though, Mark, from what we've been historically familiar with the spring game, where we see these occasional big plays, either big passes or big runs. But, you know, it's just an evolution in how to assess your team at the end of spring practice. And, frankly, I get it. And from that standpoint, as you watched individuals, it had some interest level.
Lack of big plays, I think you could take that one of two ways. First off, offensively, a lot of the big playmakers weren't playing for a variety of reasons. Yeah. Defensively, we're seeing some progress from a defense that was much maligned last season.
Yeah, I agree. There were some individuals that were quite noticeable, especially where it matters. Guys in the secondary were pretty aggressive, making plays. I know Armani Reeves certainly caught my attention. Gary and Conley caught my attention. And the true freshman linebacker from Georgia, Raquan McMillan, certainly passes the look test, as one of the old coaches used to say.
Yeah, Urban Meyer saying after the game that Raquan McMillan, he is in the rotation for the Ohio State linebackers, no doubt about it, as he is a true freshman. Some other freshmen got an opportunity today. Who did you see that impressed you?
Well, Johnny Dixon was hard to deny. They tried to get him involved as much as possible, and he was open on occasion. He was quick. He looked very comfortable running patterns. Also, the kid from Brooklyn, Curtis Samuel, is extremely quick, and you know, and that alone makes you a viable option moving forward for the Buckeyes. And what's interesting about both Dixon and Samuel, they are freshmen in the truest sense of the word. They They just got on campus in January. So Urban Meyer's recruiting will pay dividends for the Buckeyes rather soon.
And that offensive line, which had some issues today, very much a patchwork offensive line, they'll get some bodies in just in a few months from now in June, I should say. For Mike Miller, I'm Mark Koontz. Don't forget much more from the Ohio State spring game on our website, WOSN.tv and on WOSN. Andy and Matt, back to you.